Oh boy, we have a lot to talk about today. There is Nintendo's end of year, end of fiscal year financial report, and oh boy, is there a lot to digest. So sit back, I'm going to bring you all of the most important details. Now, of note, we do not have the Q&A section or whatever fully translated and happening and all that, so that's going to be a separate video for another time. But we do have the actual financial numbers as well as a few statements from the president of Nintendo, Shintaro Furukawa, on some things that we have been talking about, like new models of the Nintendo Switch. So first, let's get into some of the raw data. Nintendo, back in January, lowered their forecast of 20 million Switches this past fiscal year to 17 million, and Nintendo fell just short of that, selling 16.95 million units of Nintendo Switch. Their forecast for this upcoming fiscal year, it seems rather conservative at 18 million given the current slated lineup, but that is still a thing. So for the current slated lineup, what's interesting is that Animal Crossing and all that is still listed for this year, but Luigi's Mansion 3 was not mentioned. Hopefully that's not delayed, but again, we'll have to wait and see till closer to summertime. I don't think they would announce a delay for that game at this point. Beyond all of that, they did update their sales for software, and as of right now, 21 games have sold over a million copies on Nintendo Switch. So first, let's get into the top 10. This is listed directly on Nintendo's website. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe has now sold 16.69 million units. Super Mario Odyssey is at number 2 at 14.44 million. Super Smash Bros. Ultimate has now set a record for an individual console sale of a Smash game at 13.81 million. It still has to pass the combined sales of 3DS and Wii U from last generation, but it's probably well on its way to doing that. It also became the best-selling fighting game of all time, beating the prior Smash games record, and obviously Mortal Kombat 10 that I think sold about 11 million units. Breath of the Wild is sitting at number 4 at 12.77 million units. Still, man, like the best-selling period. And this is just Switch. You throw in the Wii U sales, it's like at 15. Like, this is crazy for Zelda. Zelda has never been as popular as it is now with Breath of the Wild. Pokemon Let's Go Pichu, Let's Go Eevee sold 10.63 million. And what's interesting about that one is when they did the last financial report in January, it had already sold 10 million. So it only sold about 630,000 units the last 3 months, which for Pokemon is not very good and does suggest that while it might end up getting to 11 million or so, that whatever projections for sales that we kind of had last year, including myself with some crazy projections, clearly is going to fall short of. It's not a failure by any stretch of the means, but it's obviously not meeting the full potential of the Pokemon franchise, as some people suggested that it wouldn't. So you guys that were all on the, hey, it might hit 10 and that's it, well, you know what? You were correct. So congrats on that. We'll have to wait and see how Pokemon Sword and Shield does at the end of this year. Splatoon 2 chimes in at number 6 at 8.7 million. I mean, that's like double what it did on Wii U. That's crazy. That's, I mean, gosh, that might hit 10 million before it's all said and done. Super Mario Party chimes in at 6,400,000 units. New Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe has sold 3.31 million. So for those wondering, why did Nintendo release that? It's already in their top 10. So, yeah, there's a reason that they released New Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe, and they definitely seemed right on that based on the sales. 1-2 Switch is next at number 9 at 2.97 million units, and Mario Tennis Aces is now officially the best-selling Mario Tennis game of all time at 2,640,000 units. Now, let's just go through the rest of the top 21 since they've been updated, but they're not necessarily showing on Nintendo's website because they only show you the top 10. And I'm getting all this information from Wikipedia, who updated it from Nintendo's financial information today. At number 11, we have Kirby Star Allies at 2,560,000 units. At number 12 is Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze, showing some legs at 2,250,000 units. ARMS hasn't really moved anywhere. That's still at 2,100,000 units. Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle, yes, heck yes, 2 million units of that sold. You know Ubisoft's got to be happy about that. You know we're getting a second one, right? We have to be. Xenoblade Chronicles 2 has sold 1,530,000 units. Octopath Traveler at number 16 with 1,500,000 units. Captain Toad Treasure Tracker at 1,180,000 units. Pokemon Tournament DX at 1,160,000 units. Yoshi's Crafted World, by the way, we got this updated today, sold 1,110,000 units. It became a million seller in just 2 days. 2 days. Yoshi's Crafted World flew off the shelves. I wouldn't be surprised if that's at 2 or 3 million, realistically, by this point. Nintendo Labo Toy-Con 1 Variety Kit is at 1,009,000 units. And, hey, we can't forget about Enter the Gungeon. That's right. Enter the Gungeon has sold 1 million units on Nintendo Switch. So, yeah, needless to say, there's a lot of million sellers here for only being on the market a little over 2 years. Crazy stuff, like 90% of that or so, like 99% of that's exclusive games. That's just wow. If you ever wonder what the difference is between Nintendo exclusives and PlayStation 4 exclusives, you only need to look at this list and look at how well these games are selling in comparison to exclusives on the PlayStation 4 that's a 100 million unit seller. Yeah, exclusives matter a hell of a lot more to Nintendo than any other platform out there. Not that they don't matter to everyone, of course, but Man, like Mario Kart 8 Deluxe is almost at 17 million, and that's a Wii U port. That it just it baffles my mind. Now, beyond all of this, Nintendo had some interesting things to say, including Satoru Furukawa, on a couple things. First, they talked briefly about Google Stadia. And Shintaro Furukawa said this. He said, "I think Google's entry is welcome in the sense that the game industry will evolve as new players enter with new technologies. I do not think that the game business will change dramatically right now, but the technology will keep on coming. I think it will be necessary to cope with it as it progresses." We also got some additional news on some other things too here. One big thing that people want to probably know about is what did Nintendo talk about the Switch Mini? They talk about the Switch Pro. And Not really. Essentially, all Shintaro Furukawa said is there are no plans to announce new hardware now or at E3. And what's interesting is right after, like hours after this came out, Nikkei published a new article basically doubling down on saying, hey, look, the cheaper Switch is coming this summer, period. It's coming. Like, our sources are not wrong. So Nintendo has been known to lie in the past before, like, you know, when they're not ready to announce something or they're about to announce something, they don't want to like spill the beans. So I don't know that we're going to see it at E3. It doesn't put it out of the range of having its own reveal trailer, its own direct. I don't think the 2DS really ever had its own deal. So it wouldn't be too shocking to see them like just drop something on Twitter one day about the Switch Mini. As much as we've been talking about it, Nintendo might not necessarily view it as big of an announcement as some of us do. But yeah, so just kind of stay tuned for that. They're saying summer, you know, June, July, August. So we'll see what happens. But, you know, the Satoru Furukawa says it's not happening at E3 anyways. And that includes anything about the Switch Pro, of course. Although, again, so Nintendo keeps things really close to the vest. So I always take any time they say they're not going to announce something as like with a grain of salt, because they have said this many times in the past and then gone on to announce it. So let's just hold on a little bit. Nintendo is really good at keeping their cards close to their vest. They also said, Satoru Furukawa mentioned about, you know, the Switch entering into China, and he said it would not actually happen soon, so it's not included in its forecast. So Nintendo's not sure if, despite their partnership with Tencent and, you know, getting everything properly filed in China and seemingly approved for sale, that Nintendo Switch would actually be able to be sold natively in all of China, in mainland China, I guess is the way to say it, at any point during this fiscal year to matter. So that could be another reason why the forecasts are only at 18 million for this upcoming year. What's interesting for those that are wondering, like, how does this all translate for Nintendo in terms of revenue? Well, their net profits are $1,700,000,000. So needless to say, Nintendo's doing just fine. Mobile games are doing great for them. They also had an announcement about Mario Kart Tour. And that was kind of unexpected, but here's what we now know about that. We now know that Mario Kart Tour will be running a closed beta from May 22nd to June 4th in Japan and the United States. And you can sign up, you know, if you have an application, you can sign up for that on the game's official website. It is going to be exclusive to Android. At least the closed beta will be that. I don't know what that means. It's going to launch on Android first and then go to iPhones later, kind of like Super Mario Run went on iPhones later and then came to Android. I'm not really sure. They had this to say about it. They said, in the mobile business, we have plans to release Dr. Mario World and Mario Kart Tour. In addition, we will strive to expand the business by ensuring that more consumers can continue to enjoy the applications we've released already. So, yeah, that's really interesting. Now, remember, Mario Kart Tour was announced last year, but we still haven't even seen it. So to go from not even seeing the game to, well, hey, look, in a month we can be in a closed beta for it is pretty interesting. I'm going to attempt to get into the closed beta myself because I do have an Android. It's going to be interesting to see if I get accepted and what that game is going to be like on mobile. But I'm pretty stoked to see in general what's going on. So what are my general takeaways from this entire thing after going through all the facts? It's that Nintendo's doing just fine. They fell short of their projections. Nintendo now has modest projections. It doesn't include China. They're continually touting no new hardware. They did this before with the 3DS, the new 3DS, and all that. So I honestly think we are just at a crossroads with Nintendo where they are trying to focus on what they have already publicly announced, which is smart of them to just focus on what is publicly announced and how they think that is going to impact sales. They think Switch as is combined with the currently announced lineup for the next fiscal year is going to sell 18 million units. They think all these games, you know, they don't know what they're going to sell at this point. Do you want them to get super ecstatic and say that Pokemon Sword and Shield is going to sell 22 million units and just project that out, or that Animal Crossing is going to sell 15? Like, it might. Both those games might do that. But Nintendo doesn't know because the sales of games on Switch are just astronomical. They are dominating pretty much every other thing they've had in the past with these franchises. You know, Zelda is just crushed. I honestly don't know if Nintendo even knows how well their stuff's going to sell. They got really bullish last year after the initial year sales and fell well short of the initial projection of 20 million and then a little bit short of 17. So I think Nintendo just wants to be conservative moving forward and be very happy to sell massively over what they have projected, especially if a Pro or a Mini or anything happens or a price cut. We haven't really talked about that. What if instead of a Pro or a Mini, they just have a price cut of Switch this holiday? That would be really, really good for Nintendo. So yeah, it's going to be interesting. It's going to be an interesting E3. We're going to have a lot to play. Maybe I'll try to find someone on the show floor if Luigi's Mansion 3 isn't mentioned during E3 to be like, hey, what's going on with Luigi's Mansion 3? Like, is it delayed? Are you just waiting until after summer because you have so many summer games coming? Because my gosh, is Switch loaded this summer? Like, major games and small games and indie games just loaded. Like, I have not seen a summer this loaded on a Nintendo platform maybe in my entire life. That's how crazy the summer is going to be. But I don't know. You guys let me know what you think about all of this stuff down in the comments below, because I could sit here and talk about this all day. I'm going to be talking about it on the podcast that releases on Monday for you guys, unless you're a patron. Then you can catch it over the weekend. I want to thank you guys for tuning in. Be sure to enter our Nintendo Switch Super Smash Bros. Ultimate Bundle through the Gleam.io link down in the description. I love all of your faces, and I will see you in the next video.